Hello, welcome to a new video of Appelboom.com. My name is Joost Appelboom and I would like to tell something in this video about the flagship pen of Lamy, the Lamy 2000. As always, if this video helps you, leave us a like, and if you're interested in this fine writing instrument, visit our store in Laren or order it online in our web store at Appelboom.com. The Lamy 2000 was first launched in 1966. After the success of the Lamy 27 model in the mid-50s. The company found itself in need of a breakout hit. They wanted to show the industry that the 26 model was not just a lucky hit. Lamy was founded by Josef Lamy, an export and branch manager of the Parker Pen Company in Heidelberg in 1930. The first name of the company was Ortos Fulharter Fabrik. It was changed after the Second World War to C. Josef Lamy. After studying economics, Dr. Manfred Lamy, son of Josef Lamy, joined the company as a marketing manager in 1962 at the age of 26. It was his idea to create a recognizable Lamy design, and as a result of this project, the Lamy 2000 pen was launched. To create this pen, Lamy contracted an influential industrial designer of the famous Bauhaus school, Gerd A. Müller. After the success of the 2000, he also designed the CP1 and the ST collection of Lamy. The Lamy 2000 became more than just a successful product. It was the foundation of the success of the Lamy company. In the year 2000, Lamy decided to offer their iconic writing instrument in metal as a special edition. This version, with some slightly changes, became an addition to the regular lineup in the year 2012. The Lamy 2000 in black comes in the standard Lamy carton gift box. The box has the Lamy logo in plastic on top of it, and the carton can be folded over it. The metal version of the 2000 comes in a more luxury carton gift box, including a polished cloth. The Lamy 2000 is standard available in two materials. There is the Macrolon version in black, and the metal version that is silver colored. Macrolon was used for the original Lamy 2000 pen. Macrolon is a trade name used for the polycarbonate from Bayer Material Science. It is a thermoplastic compound noted for its high light transmission, high heat resistance, high toughness, high dimensional stability, and good electrical insulation properties. The first formulations of Macrolon was developed in 1953. There are a lot of different grades of Macrolon, and the materials is used for a variety of different purposes. It is not known which grade of Macrolon is used by Lamy for the 2000 collection. Although the material is quite hard, the polycarbonate can get scratches, just like any other material. To minimize the visibility of micro scratches on your pen, the Lamy 2000 come in a matte brushed finish. Each pen is individually hand polished after assembly. This ensures that the brushed strike finish on the complete pen are all the same. A result of this is that the seam between the piston knob and the rest of the body is hard to see. The clip and the front section are made of brushed stainless steel. The 2000 fountain pen was the first to feature a solid stainless steel clip. On the side of the clip, you can find the brand name, Lamy. Fun fact is that this is the only visible branding on the Macrolon version of the Lamy 2000 pen. On the metal version, the clip has no brand name, but the brand name can be found on the cap, opposite of the clip. The metal version of the 2000 is not a solid stainless steel pen. That would make it too heavy to write with. In fact, a stainless steel sleeve is covering the Macrolon internal part. The available writing modes are different each finish. The Macrolon version comes as a fountain pen, ballpoint, rollable pen, four color pen, and pencil in 0.5 mm or 0.7 mm. While the metal version only comes as a fountain pen, ballpoint pen, rollable pen, and 0.7 mm mechanical pencil. The overall design of the Lamy 2000 is clearly based on the Bauhaus principle. The Bauhaus representatives emphasis on function in use, minimalism in design, and craftsmanship in production. You can recognize Bauhaus design under modern designs and practical form and function. A popular phrase to describe the Bauhaus design is form follows function, or function in design. All parts of the Lamy 2000 have a function, so we can confirm that this pen is a pen based on the Bauhaus philosophy. The pen is clearly inspired by previous projects of Mr. Müller. The shape of the pen and the ratio of metal and plastic are similar in earlier projects Müller did. On the Macrolon version, there is an ink window just above the grip section. The ink window is not very wide, but it is enough to notice if there's any ink left in the pen or not. Unfortunately, the metal version does not have this feature. Between the grip section and the barrel, there is a small metal O-ring. This ring is very important. If it is not there, or it is not in the correct place, the pen will leak. The O-ring has another feature, because it closes the gap securely with a firm click. The rollerball and the fountain pen look identical when closed. However, a small recess dot on the top of the cap show you which one is the rollerball. The Lamy 2000 fountain pen is fitted with a semi-hooded platinum finish 14 karat gold nib. Lamy is one of the few companies that produce the nibs in-house. The design of the nib is based on the nib of the Lamy 27 model of the 50s. Actually, at the beginning of the 2000 era, the both pens shared the same nib and feet assembly. Please be aware that the Lamy nibs are tested in the factory with royal blue ink. It might be possible that there are ink rests of the nib on the feet. The available nib options are extra fine, fine, medium, broad, double broad, oblique medium, oblique broad, and oblique double broad. The fountain pen uses a piston filling mechanism. Be aware that the breather hole is under the nib. The ballpoint pen uses the Lamy M16 refills, which is claimed by Lamy that they ride between 4,000 and 8,000 meters, depending on the tip size. The rollerball uses the Lamy M63 refills, which is used by all Lamy rollerballs with a cap. The 4-in-1 ballpoint pen uses the M21 ballpoint refills, which are quite smaller than the regular ballpoint refills of Lamy. The mechanical pencils uses 0.5 mm or 0.7 mm pencil leads. With the Macrolon and the metal version, Lamy offers a heavy or a lightweight option in the 2000 collection. The total weight of the Macrolon version is 25 gram, while the metal version weighs 43 gram. Both editions have the same size, and regarding most writers, the perfect size. Here you see a lineup of pens with a comparable size. The Lamy 2000, the Lamy Ion, and the Lamy Studio on the left side, and the Diplomat Aero, Pelican M800, and Visconti Homo Sapiens on the other side. Here you see the differences between the pens when uncapped. Here you see the difference between the pens when posted. This was our overview of the Lamy 2000 collection. If you're interested in the flagship pen of Lamy after watching the video, you're welcome to make your purchase in our web store. Let us know about your experience with this pen and share your thoughts and special moments using a Lamy in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe.